Hello and welcome to Paint Shop Pro Basics episode 30. Today we're covering the dodge and burn brushes. Now, to find these, it's in the exact same area as our light and darken tool, right underneath the paintbrush. Click on the right triangle, you have dodge and burn. It's an image with this white circle or the image with the black circle. The dodge tool has a shortcut of J and we'll be starting there. Now, the dodge and burn tools are complementary. Their effects are opposite of each other, whereas the dodge tool will lighten an image, the burn tool will darken one. But what's really, really interesting is that using the right mouse button, I can get the dodge tool to act like the burn tool. And it's the same way with the dodge tool. If I use the right mouse, not the dodge, the burn tool. If I use the right mouse button while using the burn tool, I can get a dodge setting. Undo this here. Now, just like with our light and darken tool, I cannot undo a dodge with a burn. However, it's a lot closer than the light and darken tool was. There is going to be some slight differences. You have changed the pixel value, and so things are going to be slightly off. But for the most part, it does a lot better with removing a dodge if you use burn. That's kind of nice to know. Burn has... Okay, dodge and burn both have a... two options that affect how they work. There's opacity, which determines the strength of the effect, and they have the limit. Now, limit is kind of fun, because limit, you can either limit to it to no limit, so it affects everything in the image, or you can limit it to your shadows, your midtones, and your highlights. Now, if you're asking, okay, what are shadows, what are midtones, and what are highlights? Well, I wasn't able to find an exact definition in the help files, and what little reference I could find in the books that I have, they weren't very specific. But here's what I found through some testing, and I've opened up my histogram palette down here for you so you can see this. Right now this is displaying the lightness. You can see we've got lots of darks, lots of midtones, and lots of highlights. Shadows refer to the first 25% of your dark colors. These are your shadowed areas. Midtones are the next 50%. So from 25% to 75% of your lightness values are your midtones. And from 75 to 100, the last 25%, those are your highlights. So when I want to affect only a certain lightness or darkness value, I can actually limit how this works. So if I wanted to brighten only the shadows, watch what happens when I do this. Now I am brightening some of the other areas because they do fall very, very close. But you'll notice most of the effect was restricted to these really dark areas. So I was still affecting some of it, but for the most part, it stuck to the shadows only. And this is a fairly dark lion, so you're going to get a lot of effects mixing. And, you know, that's pretty much it if I wanted to darken my highlights. The limits work better with certain situations than others. You know, in this one, it's a very bland image. Most of the colors are very, very close together. You will find that restricting it to the shadows will have a much larger effect than the highlights with this image. And I'm not going to explain myself any further. I'm done. That's all there is to it, folks. Opacity to determine the amount. That wasn't bad. And limit to determine what area of the image most of the effect should work on. Works with both the burn and the dodge tool. Remember, dodge is the darken. No, sorry. Dodge is the lighten, burn is the darken. So, I wanted to burn images, darken them up in places. And of course, these effects are a lot less severe than the light and darken tool. Have fun.